Hey, this is Mikey with another After Effects tutorial. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to remove logos from like a jacket and replace it with something else completely, or just leave it blank. So in this example, I'm working with a company called Ox Industrial, and we're making a video for them. And in this video, you can see he's got a logo on his jacket. Now, it actually doesn't matter in the video I'm making, but for the purposes of this tutorial, I want to show you how to be able to track this and erase it from the guy's jacket. So let's start with a brand new composition. And I'm going to bring my footage in. Okay. So here he's talking and he's moving. And I can't just easily kind of just copy and paste. I have to do some tracking in order to make it look good. Because if I were to just kind of copy this, duplicate it, and paste it, and mask it out, it'll get close, but not exactly how I want. You'd be able to see that it wasn't a perfect match. So, what I need to do is track this actually two times. So, I'm going to duplicate the footage. This top layer, I'm going to call cover. This bottom, original. And let's track the original. So, I've got this selected. I'm going to go to my tracker and I'm going to track motion. And what I want to do is I want to track position, rotation, and I don't really need to track scale, but I will just for good measure. And then let's grab this, find some track points, maybe make it a tiny bit bigger. And now I'm going to track forward. So there's my main track. This is, remember, I'm tracking position or tracking motion, and you want the tracker to be on transform, position, rotation, and scale. Now, I need a target to apply this to, and I don't have a null in here yet, so I'm going to go to layer, new, null object, and make sure that this tracker is set to the null. Right now it's set to cover, so I'm going to click it to null. Okay, and apply the X and Y dimensions. So now I've got this null object with this movement attached to it. I'm just going to close that down and hide it. Now I want to go to this cover, and what I want to do is I want to stabilize motion. So I'm going to do the same thing. Stabilize motion, rotation, and scale. And let's go in and track similar points. But this time, instead of tracking motion, I'm going to stabilize it, and you'll see the difference when I'm done. When you stabilize motion, it applies it to that footage. And when I hit apply, I'm going to hit OK. Now when we go back into this footage, you can see how everything's just kind of moving because it's stabilized around that position. And so now what I want to do is let's pre-compose this. So Command-Shift-C or Control-Shift-C on your Mac or PC. And let's call this stable. And I want to make sure I move all attributes into the new composition. Click OK. Now that I have this, I can move this wherever I want. I'm going to go ahead and just drop the opacity a little bit so I can see where I'm placing this. And let's cover up this logo. Now that I have that covered, I'm going to grab my pen tool and mask around. I can bring the opacity back up. And let's maybe feather this a little bit. So now, let's go and take this stable comp and parent it to the null. And you can see it's patched that up. Now it's not quite exactly the same color. And so what I can do is add a color correction. So let's just add a quick curves, darken that a little bit, and that seemed to match quite nicely. And the reason why I did it this way, I've seen people do this before where they just take a photograph and kind of track it in. With a photograph, you're not going to have all of this static or the noise of the video, so it's going to look, you know, not natural. Also, if there's any light changes, it's not going to work as well. So it's best to use a part of the actual video, and the only way to do that is if you stabilize it and then attach it to the track. Now, say I want to add my own logo to this. Well, that's easy. The tricky part is making it match and making it look like it is a part of the clothing. So let's grab text tool MB and let's place it where we want to. Now right now that's not looking, it's not looking like it's right. So I want to kind of skew this and maybe move it around. So let's switch it to 3D mode. And if I hit W on the keyboard, it brings up my rotate tool. And I can kind of move this. So I want to kind of place it so it's like it's on this jacket. About like that. And also the color's not quite right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off this stable. I just poked the eye out. And what I can do now is go into my text, grab the eyedropper, and I'm going to grab this color to try to make it to match. Now the next thing, let's cover that back up again, is we want to make this look more like thread. And so a way I found you can do that is with an effect, a transition called Venetian Blinds. So, but you gotta kind of get it down to basically two width, and let's change this to, okay, just a little bit more 90 degrees, and that's starting to look more kind of like it's made of threads. Now, the next thing you want to do is I like to roughen the edges a little bit. So, if you go to Effect, Stylize, Roughen Edges. And it's going to be kind of crazy, so let's bring the scale all the way down, as far as it'll go, because this is, I'm working on a small font here. Let's bring the border out, and I just want kind of the edges to work like that. And another thing is, I probably want to have the roughened edges above the Venetian blinds, so that, you know, I can still see the little stripes. And let's see that. And that's actually starting to look pretty good. I might go in to the layer styles, add a bevel and emboss. Let's come into that bevel and emboss, change it to a chisel hard. And it's starting to look like that is sewn right into the jacket. Let's fool around with the layer styles a little bit more. Let's do a drop shadow. But I don't want it to look like a drop shadow. I'm going to change the direction first, or the angle actually is what it's listed. And I want it to be kind of on the left side. Let's change the distance to 0. And the size just to give a little bit of darkness around it. And that's starting to look pretty real. Now after I got that the way I want it, I just have to simply take this and parent it to the null. So let me just render through this really quickly and you can see what it looks like. So here's the final look, and you can see it's a pretty solid track. There wasn't a lot of movement going on, but sometimes these little subtle things like this and adding in the roughened edges and the Venetian blinds to make it look more like an actual sewn-on logo is kind of what makes all the difference. So again, as a recap, the key things with this is you need to do two different tracks. You need to track the logo itself, and then you need to do a stabilized track for the patch. And if you don't do both tracks, it's not going to turn out the way you want it to. You might also have to go in and do a little bit of color correction depending on where the patch came from and if it matches the same color of what you're trying to patch. So, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, just go ahead and put them down in the comments. I'd love to answer questions. And if you have any cool tracking you've done of your own where you've taken out a logo, I'd love to see it. So just post that in the comments too. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.